from the mid-90s to the late-90s, Oliver Mtukudzi's music became more structured and his guitar melodies became more distinct and memorable. As usual, today we're just going to analyze the lead guitar because our music in Zimbabwe, it's guitar-driven and it's usually driven by the lead guitar. So we're going to analyze the song Dzoka Uyamwe, some call it Dande, and I think that song represents how Oliver Mtukudzi's music was structured. So just like the previous video, we're going to give numbers to the guitar melodies. We're going to start with this one. So this one we're going to call it melody number one, and then we're going to call it melody number two. So let's analyze the song. That's melody number one. Now the vocals have come in, and when the vocals come in, Pilani changes to melody number two. If you notice, through all the vocals, Pilani is just playing the same melody. That's a melody number two. That's the guitar solo. Now it goes back to melody number one. If you have the song, you can listen to the song on your own, but the point I'm trying to make is this song from the start to the finish has got two melodies only. One melody that was used when Oliver Mtukudzi was singing, and the other melody that was used when Pilani was doing the guitar solo. The serious repetition, that's why the melodies can stick to your mind easily. You know, as human beings, we tend to remember things that are repeated over and over and over again. And the melodies on this song are repeated over and over and over again. So, thank you.
Monolio Studio, the harmony of quality and professionalism.